Because what now, if you speak up Russia, it will mean murderer. If you speak Putin, mean murderer.
We are painted by the West as some blood, you know, thirsty monsters. It's not true. We don't want war. We know what war is. We lost 27 million lives in World War II.
Ukraina bersikeras bahwa invasi Rusia adalah kejahatan perang, sementara Rusia berpendapat apa yang dilakukannya memiliki dasar pembenaran. Saya berbicara kepada Duta Besar kedua negara dan pemerintah Indonesia. Bagaimana kelanjutan dan kemungkinan akhir dari invasi Rusia ke Ukraina?
How do you think the situation there would develop then? And what's the end goal for Russia?
For Russia, it was very clearly stated by our president, the goals of our operation. And once again, it's not a war, especially not a war against Ukrainian people. But the goal of the operation is demilitarization and denazification of Ukraine. Because Ukraine is our neighbor. We have a very long border with Ukraine, around 2,000 kilometers, if I'm not mistaken. And imagine if the military infrastructure of NATO comes to the border of Russia. Can we not feel threatened by this kind of development? Of course we do.
Ukraine will not surrender. That's what they didn't expect. Because it is not the war between like armies. It's not the attack of Russian army on Ukrainian military force. Mm-hmm. Or it's not attack of Russia on Ukrainian government. No, it is the war against nation. It is the attack on Ukrainian independence, sovereignty, and on lives of civilians of the whole country. So now we have united nation, absolutely united country, like with this very strong will to defeat the enemy, mm-hmm. and the whole nation fights.
What about the autonomy of Ukraine as an independent nation to make their own decisions, if they want to join NATO or not, or EU or not? What do you think about that?
The people of Ukraine should be asked, not just a puppet government installed by the West, but the free will of Ukrainian people should be considered. During these 8 years, no one was asking Ukrainian people what they really want. And I'm sure that if there will be no pressure from outside, if the minds of Ukrainians are not manipulated by their puppet government and the Western propaganda, the answers would be quite different. We are not in the state of war with Ukraine. We're not fighting against Ukrainian people. Ukrainian people, we see them as our brothers and sisters. We are practically the same people. And we don't want to hurt any civilians. That's why we're talking with the Ukrainian side on humanitarian passages so that civilians could be spared.
You don't talk and kill in the same time. If you want to, like, show your will, to just, you know, demonstrate your willingness for something, first what you have to do is to stop killing civilians, stop bombing the cities, and that's what they cannot do.
What do you think of the sanctions and exclusions imposed to your country by the world?
Don't tell me about the world, because US and their allies are not the whole world, and majority of countries did not join the sanctions. There are different aspects to this situation. First of all, they're absolutely absurd and illegitimate, and you know, the West behaves like, you know, bandits, because when they froze assets of our central bank, it's just theft, it's just stealing. I'm not telling that it will not hurt. Of course, we will have some hard times, but we've learned our lessons. We will do whatever we can to make the Russian economy not dependent on our Western partners.
You wrote an open letter to the Indonesian government recently. Can you tell us again what are the key messages in the letter?
I think in the situation like this, when the military catastrophe is happening, humanitarian catastrophe is happening, war crimes are committed in huge scale in Ukraine. In this situation, I would hope that every nation of a goodwill, especially proud nation of Indonesia, every nation should stand up and condemn the aggression. Not just to condemn the war as it is, not just to condemn the aggression as it is, whatever, but to name the aggressor, to name the invader.
Apa hasil pertemuan antara Ibu Menlu dengan Duta Besar Ukraina dan Rusia?
Fokus Ibu Menteri adalah tentu menyampaikan ada dua hal utama. Yang pertama tentu masalah kembali menyampaikan posisi Indonesia dan alasan mengapa posisi tersebut diambil. Saat ini penting adalah untuk deeskalasi, turunkan tensi, dan stop peperangan. Karena situasi kemanusiaannya sudah sangat mengkhawatirkan. Yang kedua, yang selalu Ibu sampaikan adalah tentang humanitarian corridor, safe passage, tentang aspek kemanusiaannya. Karena itu sangat penting, kita lihat berapa juta orang yang sudah meninggalkan Ukraina menurut data UNHCR terakhir, dan juga termasuk di dalamnya tentu evakuasi warga negara kita, itu termasuk di antaranya.
Okay, one who is positive stays at home. What do you think of Indonesia's statement and position regarding the war in Ukraine?
Of course, I will be frank. We are disappointed by the decision of Indonesia that we see as our good partner and friend to act as a co-sponsor of the General Assembly, UN General Assembly resolution condemning Russia as an aggressor, but of course we still see Indonesia as our friend and partner, and we hope that this situation will not affect our bilateral relations.
Absolutely, that's what happened.
So you want more than just a statement, although statement would you would appreciate that, but like action, real action from the Indonesian government, is that?
That will, yes, that's true. I would expect anything, but anything but silence. That's what I would expect. Maybe it could be the humanitarian aid of Indonesia to Ukrainian people. Anything, because anything, any voice counts. And Indonesia is a big country. It's a proud nation, as I repeat, with glorious history, glorious past, and glorious future. Indonesia is not just regional leader. It's not just a leader in ASEAN, and like I would say that it's a stronghold for ASEAN peace and stability, but it's also it is becoming the world global force, the global force.
Irak ataukah itu? Kalau perang ini terus-menerus berlanjut ya, dampaknya tentu terhadap Indonesia dan dunia terasa. Harga minyak, ya, harga gas dan lain-lain. Semuanya sudah obvious dan akan pasti berdampak kepada ekonomi dunia. Dan di tengah pandemi saat ini, fokus kita tentu adalah bagaimana kita memfokuskan energi kita untuk bisa keluar dari pandemi itu.
What's your wish for the Indonesian people or the Indonesian government regarding the situation in Ukraine?
War, that's not our wish, that is not our choice. But I can assure you, by conducting this military operation, we're trying to prevent some bigger tragedy from happening. And of course, we want peace. We want to live in peace with Ukraine, with our good neighbors, our relatives, our brothers and sisters. And but sometimes when you exhaust all the other means, you have to take some drastic measures.
Don't be afraid of your enemies. The maximum they can do to you is to kill you. Don't be afraid of your friends. The maximum they can do for you, to you is to betray you. Be afraid of indifferent. Be afraid of those who don't care. Because it's because of the silent consent. All the murders, all the betrayals take place in this world.